Hey everyone, Cass here, and SideQuest has gotten a big design overhaul, and because of that, the developer asked me to do an updated guide on how to use their platform. Since I love the work that they do for the community and they make my life easier as a content creator, I wanted to support them, so here we are. I've made a similar guide on SideQuest before, so you might recognize these steps if you've seen the last video, but I've updated some of these steps with answers on questions that I got from that last video, so hopefully this will help even more people. Be sure to check out the timestamps below if you are looking for something specific, and if you like what you see, consider subscribing to see more VR videos like this one, and now let's get started. If you don't know what SideQuest is, here's a quick introduction. SideQuest is the unofficial source for apps and games for the Oculus Quest and Go. Essentially, it's a platform that allows you to download an app or a game that is not on the official Oculus store. This is called sideloading. Sideloading is usually a pretty technical process, but SideQuest makes it a lot easier. While the initial setup can take some work, you only have to do it once, and after that, installing new games will be very simple. I'll show you how to do the initial setup in just a bit. Please keep in mind that SideQuest is not for pirated games, as some might think. We do not advocate doing that. The games and apps listed on SideQuest are games that might have been rejected on the Oculus Store, or they could be early access builds that developers seek feedback for, or something else. SideQuest lists these games and apps that you can discover using handy filters, and it even has a user review system. I'll show you what you can do in SideQuest later in the video, but let's start with how to install and use it yourself. First, every link that I mention in these coming steps will be listed in the description below for your convenience. SideQuest is also always in development, so your SideQuest version might look different than mine if you're watching later, but if any big changes happen, I will keep you updated here on this channel. But in any case, the SideQuest version I'm using right now is version 0.10.7. And now, let's move to step 1. Download and install SideQuest. Okay, now go to the first link, sidequestvr.com setup how to, and find the download button here. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to download the Windows version. Before you install SideQuest, it's important for me to note that if you've ever used ADB or Screen Copy, you have to make sure that you remove old versions and also any environment variables that you might have added for it. It just messes up this setup. So if you don't know what ADB or Screen Copy is, then you're probably good to go. So once it's done downloading, just open it here, show in folder, double click it and install it. There's no need to start it yet because there's a few steps that we have to do before we can actually use it. So I'm going to uncheck this and click finish. Step 2. Register as a developer on Oculus. To sideload on your Oculus Quest, you have to put your headset in developer mode. But before you can do that, Oculus requires you to register as a developer and accept their developer agreement. Thankfully, this is a free process. Now, to do this, go to dashboard.oculus.com. Make sure you are logged in using the same Oculus account that you are using for your quests. If you've never done this before, you should be redirected to this Create New Organization page. Here you can just fill out the name of your organization, click I understand, and then submit. Here you have to agree to the terms. Once you've agreed, you should be put on this page and your account will be seen as a developer account, and it will add some settings to your accounts that's otherwise not accessible. Step 3. Install the drivers. Now go to this developer.oculus.com link. I've put the whole link in the description at step 3. You should go to this page. Here you have to accept the terms and click download. Now go to the downloaded file by clicking here and then show in folder. Here you can unzip it. I'm using 7-zip for this, which is a free open source file archiver. But if you're on Windows 10, you can also use the built-in zip extraction tool that's available to you if you right-click the file, and then you can click extract all over here. Now go inside the extracted folder until you find the Android winusb.inf file. So it could be that you don't see the .inf file name extension like I'm seeing right here, but that's okay. Just make sure you have the Android WinUSB file. But if you really want to make sure, you can also go to view and then check this box right here, and it will get you the .inf file name extension. But only do this if you know what it does. Like right now, I'm going to uncheck it and you will see what it looks like. Just make sure you have this file, Android WinUSB, right click it, click install. Now you will get a pop-up that asks you to allow this app. to make changes, just click yes, and then you will see this pop-up that it's completed successfully. And here you can just click OK. Step 4. Enable developer mode and reboot. Now get your Oculus Quest headset and a smartphone or a tablet, whatever you install the Oculus app on. Now make sure your Oculus Quest is booted and turned on. In the Oculus app, go to settings below. Then tap on the Oculus Quest that should show up and then wait until it connects. Then in this drop down right here, you have to tap more settings and go to developer mode, and here you have to turn on developer mode. I already have it turned on. Then go back one setting and check unlock pattern. Here you have to make sure that you did not turn on unlock pattern here. If you see set unlock pattern like my screen right here, then you're fine. If you do have this on, make sure you turn it off for this process to work. And now last step here is to reboot your Oculus Quest just in case. Just hold press the power off button until you hear this sound. Step 5. Connect a USB cable. We are almost done, yay, but first make sure your Oculus Quest is turned on again if you've powered it off before. Now find a compatible USB cable to connect the Oculus Quest to your PC where you downloaded SideQuest. On the cable that came with the Oculus Quest, which is the one I have right here, will work as well. In my previous video, I said it didn't work. I think I was confused with something else, so I stand corrected. You can use most other USB 3.0 cables too, as long as it supports data transfer. You can try a phone cable, for example. I've also used my official Oculus Link cable as well. Now connect one end of the USB cable to your Quest and the other end to your PC. Step 6. Launch SideQuest and allow USB debugging. With your Oculus Quest now connected to your PC, you can now start SideQuest. Before it connects, a prompt in the headset will ask you to allow USB debugging access. Put on your headset and click allow with your controller. You have to select always allow from this computer too. This avoids this message popping up every time you connect the cable. Now you might get a couple of other pop-ups inside the headset, depending on if it's your first time connecting a USB cable or whether you're using the Oculus Link cable. Just make sure that if the pop-up asks you to allow access to the device with a USB cable, click allow using your controller. And if it asks you to enable Oculus Link, click not now. Once you've done that, the SideQuest app on your PC should show at the top left corner that your Oculus Quest is connected with this little green dot. And that's it for making SideQuest work. You are now ready to have some fun with side loading. Every step after this is optional and depending on what you want to do. Again, you can check the timestamps in the description to see if there's something that might be useful for you, or you can just keep on watching. You can now browse SideQuest for any games or apps that you would like to try out. I will also let you know how to do this in the next step, but could you leave me a like first if you found this video helpful at all? It would help me a lot. Thank you. Step 7. Sideloading games and apps and how to launch it. The first app I recommend you to install is a handy app launcher. So with your Oculus Quest still connected to the SideQuest app, look for the app launcher right here in the search field. Then just click on the thumbnail and right here you will see the install latest button. Click on it. And it will now install on your Oculus Quest directly, and if it succeeds, you will see a message at the bottom saying that all tasks are completed. You see here. Now if you put on your Oculus Quest, I will tell you where to find the app launcher now. As you can see, the Oculus Quest also got a cool new user interface, so it's a little bit different. The unknown sources that we have to find is a little bit hidden now, but to get there, just go to this icon right here. It's the app launcher icon. And then go to all apps right here at the left, and then at the top here you can click on the all drop down menu, and if you scroll down here with your joystick you find unknown sources right here now, and you can see the Quest app launcher right here. At least I think it's this one. Ah, so yes, this is the SideQuest one. This is just a handy app that allows you to more easily launch any app that you've installed on your Oculus Quest, even the sideloaded ones. So this step works the same for any games or apps that you might want to install via SideQuest. But sometimes you might need to install your own APK file, then you can also pretty easily do this manually by going to this icon right here, click on it, and then select the APK file that's on your computer. Now let's talk about this cool feature of SideQuest that allows you to record and livestream Oculus Quest content wired and wirelessly and on every platform, not just on Facebook. But this process used to be very tedious because it uses ADB and it's pretty technical, but SideQuest makes a streamer's life like ours and maybe possibly yours so much easier. Before we start, do keep in mind that this method does not record any gameplay audio, so you will need to do a few extra things to capture that as well, which I explain in a different video. I will put a link in the description once it's done. You might wonder now though why you would use this method to record, as you can also use the integrated recording feature on the Quest itself, which you can find under the sharing icon and then record a video. Since this method does capture gameplay audio, I agree, this method is pretty great if you are making regular gameplay videos. Both methods have pros and cons. Like with the integrated recording option, you cannot record best through camera footage. Then there's also the limitation of Oculus, where you can't live stream on other platforms that are not Facebook. With the SideQuest method, the cons are no gameplay audio, and sometimes there's a horizontal tear in the middle of the video, which doesn't look as good, but you can record everything you want to show and live stream everywhere. So I think this last method is the best when you are looking to live stream, and when you just want to record for a video, I recommend using the integrated option. So let's get started with SideQuest. There are only 3 steps for this. So step 8, connect your Oculus Quest to your PC. Make sure you have done step 1 to 6 already. If you haven't, step 7 is optional. And now connect your Oculus Quest to your PC with a compatible USB cable like we did before. Now start SideQuest and wait until your Oculus Quest connects with SideQuest. You can see that at the top left here. Right now it's connecting, but once this turns green, like this, when it looks like this, you're good to go. Step 9, enable Wi-Fi mode in SideQuest. Now you can enable Wi-Fi mode by clicking on this icon right here and then click connect. Now you have to wait until the status bar says that there is a Wi-Fi connection, and once that's done, you can unplug the cable. Alright, so I unplugged my cable, and as you can see in my SideQuest app on my PC, at the top left here, in the status bar, it is still connected, so that's good. You can now move on to step 10, but I have a quick note for those that might have some trouble here. If you don't see these two wireless icon and the streamer icon, then you might need to sign up for a SideQuest account, and also make sure that you are logged in. If you see an avatar right here like mine, then you know that you are logged in. If during this step you have any other problems, like if you get any error messages, then I recommend restarting the server. You can do this pretty easily as well. Here in SideQuest, at the top right corner here, at the run ADB commands, just click on it. And here you have a couple of commands. You can try disconnect everything, and you can also try reset ADB. Once you've done that, you have to restart at step 8 of my guide, but this does usually solve any problems you might have. Step 10, launch the streamer. Now you can launch the streamer by clicking on this icon right here at the top right, and then you can choose to adjust a couple of settings here. But you can also leave it be if you don't know what it all means. Click start stream here to start seeing a window of what your headset is actually seeing. If you see a bit of lag like I'm seeing right now over here, then you have to make sure that your Oculus Quest has a really good Wi-Fi connection, preferably a 5 GHz connection. That should solve the problem. Now you can just record this window using your favorite recording software, like OBS for example. I use OBS, so what I do in OBS is just get the window capture, and then I just choose the SideQuest stream, and you can record whatever you're seeing. As you can see, these default streamer settings usually look pretty good. It gives you this cropped widescreen footage of what you see in the headset, but you can change that to non-cropped versions as well. If you do want to play around with these settings, then I recommend reading up on it on this screen copy page, as this is the tool that SideQuest uses for the streamer. I put a link at step 10 below in the description. Now you might want to do wired recording instead of wireless, then all you need to do is step 8 and step 10, so you can ignore step 9 where we turn on Wi-Fi mode. So that's it for the guide section of this video. Now it's just up to you, as either a new or experienced Oculus Quest player, to have some fun and enjoy diving in into the dreamy worlds of virtual reality. So if you want some tips on where to get started, I recommend checking the shooter Pavlov and the handset tracking apps like Cubism VR. But there's a lot on here that even I haven't tried yet, so I also suggest just clicking through Side Quest. You can click browse here and select a genre that you like. And if you're not sure about the game, you can always check the user reviews if you scroll down. All pretty incredible work, right? I almost can't imagine how this is mostly done by one developer and his wife, so thanks to them for making our lives a bit easier. Before we end this video, I also have to mention this as a little warning. When sideloading, please keep in mind that you are putting software on your device that has not been approved by Oculus and could potentially harm or damage your device, even if it looks okay. It's also good to be aware of the Oculus content guidelines when sideloading content to ensure that you're not violating anything, because doing any violations could get your Oculus account blocked. The things listed on SideQuest should be fine, like I'm still using it, but of course you never know if Oculus might change their policy, so I will try to keep up to date with their guidelines just in case. Anyway, I really hope this helps you out. If you have any questions at all, leave them down below as soon as possible. I will try to answer them in the coming days, but any time later might be a little bit difficult for me. Also, let me know in the comments what you think of SideQuest and what you are going to do with it. I'd love to get some tips as well. So, thanks for being a supporter of this channel by watching this entire video. We appreciate you, and a special thanks goes to my right-hand patron, Baxon VR. I recommend checking out his YouTube channel too. And as always, VR on.